Welcome to the show. This week on the show, we are going to achieve a sense of balance in paintball, the yin and the yang. We are going to show you how to become one with the paintball universe and achieve total nirvana. Okay, enough of this stupid hippie thing. Let's go shoot stuff. Alright, all kidding aside, this week on the show we're going to talk about what I call Zen shooting, which is shooting from the hip, but you don't literally shoot from the hip, there's no accuracy here at all. No, we're going to talk about shooting without actually aiming. So what I'm going to try to teach you this week is how to use something that you already know how to do in order to aim without actually looking down the barrel of the gun. And what I'm going to teach you how to do is use just this. See, here's how it works. Almost everybody in the universe can point at something and inherently know exactly where it's at. For example, I'm going to point to the snake. Right there. Matter of fact, we're going to do this as a take-home experiment. Right now, wherever you're sitting, point to the door you walked in the room at. See, you didn't have to look. You just know exactly where your finger is pointing. I mean, you've lived with it all your life, you know exactly where it is. Now we're just going to apply that same principle, except we're going to put a paintball gun in. When you grab the pistol, the grip of your paintball gun, instead of grabbing it normally with your index finger and your middle finger, we're going to slide the index finger right alongside the rail, so that it's parallel and straight with the barrel. And we're going to slide the other fingers in onto the trigger. Now we're ready to show off. So we're going to start with a big target and then work our way down. Remember, you've got the index finger pointing the same direction that the barrel is going. So when you want to shoot a target, all you have to do is point. And you know exactly where it's going. Pull this shot off, it's going to be a miracle. And it's just a matter of point and shoot. Take six. If I can't do it on this one, we'll just call it that. So with your index finger pointing straight down the barrel, that's where the ball is going to go, straight where your index finger is pointing. So all you need to do is see the target, point the gun with your index finger, and shoot. Hopefully, like this. Yeah, I know that's not a Mountain Dew bottle. I got yelled at by somebody for drinking way too much Dew, so. Now the best place you can practice this, of course, is at your local paintball field on target range. So we're going to do, first of all, the index finger trick. We're just going to slide the index finger parallel to the barrel, point, and shoot. One of the other drills that you can do requires that you have a friend of yours help you out. Jim is setting up four targets on the target range, and he's going to stand next to me and give me a number, 1, 2, 3, or 4. That's the target I got to hit. If I miss, it's his turn, and I call out a number for him.
1.
There's no real winners or losers in this. All you're doing is you're training yourself to get better.
3. 1.
As a matter of fact, you can practice this skill without firing any paint at all. All you need to do is grab your paintball gun, hold it with your index finger so that it's pointing once again, and then just find the target and point. The idea is you want to learn how to make the paintball gun an extension of your hand. That way it becomes second nature to just bring it up to whatever position you like to shoot in and point. It's just a matter of familiarity, folks. There's no real voodoo secret behind it. Except to that. There's a secret to that. Now, whenever you're doing this drill at home, remember, you're not doing this for speed. You're trying to learn how to become a little bit more accurate. So go ahead and take your time. The key is you just want to learn how to point with your finger and hit what you're pointing at. Not too shabby. Now, eventually, you will get to the point where you'll be able to just point your index finger at something and be able to put a paintball on it. That is the point that you want to put your fingers back down onto the triggers. That way you can start walking the trigger or raking the trigger or whatever your preferred high volume of shooting method is. The reason is that by then you have learned that the barrel can be an extension of your hand. And you'll just be able to instinctively put the barrel in one position and shoot things. And once you've done that, you have achieved total enlightenment. Or something like that. But we're going to talk about learning how to put your hopper on tight.
Dang. Oops.
And how not to use electrical tape when you're putting your hopper on. I think that's the lesson of the day here.